So in this class, I will discuss about the fuel emission diode as a rectifier. So here, the process in which alternating current or alternating voltage is converted into a direct voltage or direct current is known as the rectification. The device is used for this process for the rectifier. The fuel emission diode has the property of offering low resistance and allowing current to flow in the power bias effect. This property is used in the course of the rectification. There are two types of rectifier. In the course of the rectification, those are the upper rectifier and full wave rectifier. The full wave rectifier will further divide into two types. There is a setup of full wave rectifier and bridge type rectifier. First, we will discuss about the upper rectifier. Upper rectifier, you see the upper rectifier is a circuit which rectifies half wave of the AC wave. This is called the upper rectifier. So next, so see the here the conversion of alternating voltage to direct current. So this involves a device that only allows one way flow of electron. For example, there is no rectification to complete wave is traveling. If it is for a half wave rectifier, you can get the signal only positive peaks of the input signal. If we give next to the full wave signal. So even negative half cycle also you can get in the pulses type, in the pulses way, in the pulses type. Okay. So this is the figure of the upper rectifier. So in this, in which only the positive or negative portion of the signal is remained. For example, if you give the input signal AC input here, so to the transformer, that is a step down transformer. So that means whatever the giving AC input that is given to the primary of the transformer and getting the output at a secondary. So that is given to the diode. So diode is initially give the positive offsetting. So positive diode is connected to the power terminal and P is positive power terminal and the diode internal connected to the negative terminal. And automatically, so this signal is allowed to the, because diode is in forward bias. So whatever the giving input positive voltage that will be traveled to this diode, that means diode is in closed switch. And you can take the output at the ratios. That means this is the output of the first one. So if we give it to the negative option, we move into the negative option, so automatically diode is in reverse bias because here the connections, we are giving the negative thermal here and here the positive thermal. So that's why so diode is a reverse bias. Diode is in reverse bias, it acts as a open circuit. There is no current is flowing from this secondary of the transformer to the output of the resistor circuit. Then if there is no current going, automatically that is a zero. Again, during the positive cycle, so it will be as this positive signal at the output. So this is the upper rectifier. Next, so we show the picture upper rectifier by AC voltage, here the rectifier is obtained from the secondary ends of the, there is a good secondary signal S1 in S2 to the transformer. And already discussed this in the previous slide. So, that is the P end of the diode is connected to the S1 of the secondary coil, and the N end of the diode is connected to the, that means the N side of the diode is connected to the S2 of the secondary coil of the transformer. Through load resistance RL. And the rectifier output voltage VD is appear across the load resistance RL. So, during the positive offside of the input AC voltage, here S1 will be positive and the diode is a forward bias and then it conducts. And therefore, current flows through the circuit and there is a voltage for the person. This gives the output voltage at one in the figure. So, if you're giving the positive off cycle, automatically you get the same during the positive off cycle, you can get the as it is. So, during the negative off cycle, that means there is no signals. So, during the negative off cycle, the input is voltage Vs, S1 will be negative and the diode is in reverse bias and the diode does not conduct. So no current to the circuit and the voltage of the pressure is zero and no output voltage of time. So that's corresponding to the an alternating input voltage by we are giving input voltage alternating voltage but getting the unidirectional pulsating output is of time. So the ratio of the DC power output to the AC power input is not rectifier efficient. In general, after rectifier efficiency is 45% 6%. And here is a, you see the 0 to 5 is a diode is in, that means 0 to, during the 0 to 5 diode is in off condition, that is the current I not equal to 0. And the 5 to 5 diode is in off condition, that is equal to 0. Here you are giving the signal, voltage signal VF in physical VF sin omega t, that is in the duration, that means 0 less than or omega less than 2 pi. So that is the in between signal available. And similarly, that is in right in terms of the, you can write in terms of the current also. Okay, no? It is all in the RL is the low resistance, RF is the diode power resistance. So here, DC or DC, we will find out in off rectifier, DC voltage, RF, average voltage, and similarly RMS value voltage form factor and triple factor. So here, DC voltage is IDC, that is equal to 1 by 2 pi, 0 to 2 pi, I of alpha into d alpha. I of alpha is what? I am alpha d alpha. So here, the condition, that means limit is 0 to 2 pi, but during 0 to 5 we have the signal is available, and 0 to 5 to 2 pi, there is no signal. That means 0 to 2 pi, 1 by 5, integral of 0 to 2 pi, I am sin omega d alpha, plus 1 by 5, 0 to 2 pi, 0 d alpha. Because second half cycle, there is no signal. And here, that means integration of this sign minus cos alpha. In the limits are 0 to pi. So we get the minus im by pi into minus cos alpha, that equal to minus im by pi. Limit, you can apply limits cos alpha means cos pi. Cos pi is minus 1 and also cos 0 also minus 1. So minus 1 minus 1 minus 2. And you minus minus cancel. And here, you can get the only. Cos pi, because cos pi is the manual, IDC is equal to IM by 5. Then, so, here, and that is IDC. So, next, VDC is equal to IDC into load resistance, that is equal to IM by 5 into RL. So, that can be right in terms of the IM by RL, RL plus RF into RL by 5. So, that means VDC is equal to VM by 5. Simply, IDC is equal to IM by 5, VDC is equal to VM. And next the RMS value moving iron meter rating. But IRM is equal to root square of the 1 by 2 pi, the integration of 0 to 2 pi, I square alpha into d alpha. So I square alpha, I can write, that means I square means IRM sin alpha also. That is equal to, you can write into 1 minus cos alpha by 2 pi square. So simplify this, that means here 1 by 2, that means here 2 terms are there, 1 by 2 minus cos alpha by 2. So that means I square, I m square by 4 pi, 5 minus sin to 4 by pi, minus 0 minus sin 0 by 8. So we can get, apply the limits and get the final optical IRM is equal to root of I m square by 4 pi, that equal to I m by 2. Okay. So next to form factor, that is the RMS value of the rectifier input signal by DC, that means IRMS by DC. So already you get the IRM is equal to IM by 2 and IDC is equal to IM by 5. So you can get the 5 by 2, that is equal to 1.57. And next is the ripple quantity, very, very important examination point of view. And measuring the fluctuating components is given by this rectifier. It means capacitors, that means filters are used to bring the wave component. So the ripple factor is equal to RMS value of the ripple signal by the DC value. So for example, if you see the picture, so how much AC signal is available at the output? But finally we get the DC signal. So there is no AC signal at the output of the rectifier. That means we will get only DC signals. That means we want to remove the AC signal. For that purpose, we are using the filters. Okay, we'll discuss in the later. So this is the I alpha signal, this is the I dash alpha signal, this is the peak value, this is the average value, and this is the IDC value. Okay, and here is the IRM is equal to I dash RMS is equal to root of 1 by 2 pi 0 to pi I alpha d alpha. So here, that means here I dash alpha is equal, that means you see the picture, I alpha is equal to I dash alpha minus IDC. So total signal is this I alpha. So this part is the I dash alpha and this is the IDC. That means you can combine I dash alpha plus IDC is equal to I alpha. Or you can write I dash alpha is equal to I alpha minus IDC. So here I dash alpha equal I alpha minus I dg. I alpha is that means I dash alpha is equal. So in terms of IRMS double, I dash RMS is equal to 1 root of 1 by 2 to 0 to pi alpha d alpha. So that you can write in terms of the I dash alpha plus you can write I alpha into IDC. So replace I alpha plus I dash alpha plus you can write I alpha minus IDC. So that is under root of the 1 by 2 pi 0 to pi I alpha minus IDC whole square d alpha. So substitute, that means integrated IA, that means in mathematics A minus B whole square J square minus B square plus A square minus B square minus A square plus B square minus B square. Similarly here, I alpha minus IDC square is equal to IR, that means similarly I alpha square and IDC square minus 2 into I alpha into IDC. So here, so you can write and apply the problem and integrate it and get the value. So whatever that means, final value is equal to I dash RM is equal to root of IRM square minus IDC square. So that is the ripple factor is nothing but root of IRM I square RMS by, that means IRM square minus IDC square by IDC. So finally you get the value is the only, that is, you know, the form factor value is nothing but simply that is the ripple factor. We can also in terms of the form factor, that is form factor square minus 1 under square under root. So that equal 1.57 whole square minus 1 under root, that equal to, we can get the 1.21 in half a red square, the ripple factor is 1.21. Okay, next, that is if we take the full wave rectifiers in which either positive or negative portion of the inverter, so that the entire signal has a, so here the signal here we are using center trap transfer full wave rectifier. So let's see, means here is the signal is given to the transformer primary and getting the output primary transformer secondary. There is A and B, there is a in between zero point, that is the center point. That is here the voltage, whatever voltage is given, that will be splitted to equal parts. Initially, that means during positive off cycle, so this diode is on condition, so that means we will get the positive off cycle. So during negative off cycle, that means during positive cycle, this diode D1 is on and D2 is off, and we can get the only positive portion. During negative off cycle, D1 is off condition, D2 is in on condition, that's why we can get the second, that means one more cycle. So similarly, during positive off cycle, D1 on, D2 off, we can get the positive off signal as this. And during negative off cycle, D1 off, D2 is on, so we can get the, that means other pulses in this output. So similarly, this operation like this. And next is the, see the picture. So I will show the whatever I told that will be shown in pictures. Full wave rectifier is a type of rectifier which converts alternating current voltage into pulsating direct current voltage during both positive off cycle applied input voltage. This rectifier acts as a part of circuitry which allows the sensors to attend the receivers in either polar. So for example, if you are giving them 230 volts with the AC supply, so that means output is 0 to 9 volts between AC. And CB also 0 to 9, that is also 9 volt. During positive portions, diode D1 is conductant, that means as this you can get the output at the V0. And during at that time D2 is reverse biased. And during negative off cycle, D1 is in non-conduction, that is a non-off condition. And the same time D2 is in on condition. So that means you can get the one pulses. So that is during positive off cycle is positive pulse, during negative off cycle we can get the second, that means negative off cycle in the from the counter. Okay, so that means in if we take the AC signal, so from 0 to pi, that is a positive off cycle, so diode D1 is on, D2 is off condition, and pi to 2 pi, that means pi to 2 pi, that means D1 is off condition and D2 is off condition. Okay. And this is center trap transformer. Two diodes are here using. They are connected to the center trap transformer, secondary winding of the transformer. The both are two diodes connected to the two ends of the transformer. And the center trap divides the total secondary voltage in equal parts. The center trap is usually considered as a ground point. Center trap is usually considered as a ground point or the zero voltage reference. Okay, so here we see the picture. Current flow due to the power flow observation. If you apply the 0 to T by 2 in terms of the time, and here either we can get the same as that means D1 is conditioning, diode is on, that is equal to switch, D2 is off condition. So you can get the same signal as this. During negative off cycle, here you see the second position, and this diode D1 is open switch and diode D2 is in closed switch, and we can get the second off like this. So this will be during positive operation, one pulse is get pulsating, AD signal available, and during negative off cycle, second pulse is. So during on pulses are continuous pulses will get in at the output of the over rectifier. Okay, and next is the see here pictures. During this picture, in this case of the rectification, you get the complete input signal to the positive portion like this one figure. So this is your input signal, AC input gateway. That way we can get the output from the D1 and D2. So this course is due to the D1. This is coming one D1, D2, this is D1, this is D1. D1 on, D2 off. D2 on, D1 off. So D1 on, D2 off. And if D2 on, D2 off. These are the. So here, this signal is given to the capacitor, so to get the complete DC voltage. So we will see the capacitor in the next topic. Okay. Here also we will find out the average voltage, the RMS value, which is back current form factor. So here in the after effect, we will give the one pulses from 0 to 5. You can get the only 0 to 5. But here in the in full wave rectifier, we will a 0 to 2.5, you can add the 2 pulse, 0 to 5 also pulse, or 5 to 2.5 as the same pulse. That means you can calculate the one pulse, that means the time period 0 to 5 there. So if you get that one, you can get the all the total average power. That means IDC is equal to IDC is 1/5, 0 to 5, I alpha D alpha, that is equal to I alpha is nothing, I am sin alpha D alpha. So that means integrate sin alpha is equal to minus cos alpha, integrate value is limits are 0 to 5. So that is minus I m by 5 minus cos alpha. So that is minus I m by 5 into so cos alpha and cos 5 minus 1, cos 1, cos 0 also minus 1, minus 1 and so minus 2, minus minus I will cancel. So here that means ID is equal to 2 I m by 5. That means BDC is equal to 2 V m by, that means yes, that is also within the 2 V m by 5. IDC is equal to IM 2IM of I, VDC is equal to VM. And is the RMS root mean square value. So that here is the integration of 1/5, 0 to the under square root of the 1/5, integration of 0 to 5 square alpha d alpha. So here is, you can write sin square alpha in terms of the 1 minus cos square alpha by 2. So IM square by 2, that means take out right side. That means here 1/5, that is I square m by 2/5, you can take outside. So that means you can get the value here 1/2 minus cos alpha 2 d alpha. So 1/2 is the 1, that means 5/2, and pi, that is pi, minus sin 2 pi, you can write sin 2 pi, apply limits, so you can get the value the I square m by 2/5. So finally, that is IRM is equal to IM by root 2. Then IRM is equal to IM by root 2. And similarly, for form factor is that RMS value is IRMS by DC. So that means IM by root 2 by 2M by 5. That is equal to 5 by 2 root 2. That is 1.1. Yeah. Okay? And form factor. So ripple factor is nothing but. So here, ripple factor is nothing but. Same I dash alpha equal to I alpha minus IDC. Same formula. But instead of using I alpha plus, you can write alpha square a minus b, similarly a minus b whole square a square plus b square minus b. So apply the limits and we can get the value is equal to IRMS is equal. Simply you can get the root of IRMS equal minus ID square. So that means you can get the value is equal to simply IRMS by is equal to, you can get the root of IRMS square minus ID square minus ID square, that means 1. So that means under root of IRM by IDC whole square is the form factor whole square. You can write ripple factor in terms of the form factor square minus 1 whole to the power 1/2. That equal to 1.11 whole square minus 1 under to the power of 1/2. You can get the 0.458. That is the ripple factor full variant. Okay. And next is the bridge rectifier. So in bridge rectifier, four diodes are used. The four diodes are arranged in the form of the bridge type. So the path during path of cycle, there is a B1, B2, D3, D4, there are 4 dash for easy. So during path of cycle, like signal, thermal M is positive. So here, this is M is positive, and with respect to the thermal M. And due to this diode D1 and D3, this diode D1 and D3 is positive, that means diode is conducted, and the D2, D4 are then non-conducted. And it results in the current I close to the load resistance below D1 and D3. That means during positive off cycle, diode D1 and D3 is conducting, D2, D4 is then non-conducted. That means D1, D3 is diode are on, D2, D4 is then off. So we can get the value positive off cycle. So during L2 off cycle, that means here M is negative and N is positive. That means here, see the picture. So during L2 off cycle, we can get the signal like this one. So here starting from here, that means you move the position and this resistor and through this one, through this diode D1, and you move into the N-type. This is during L2 off cycle. Similarly, during negative off cycle, so starting from the, because during negative off cycle, N is positive and M is negative. So that means here positive will be starting from in and go to the D4 and to the ratio and come back to this one and come back to the D2 and come back to the L. So this is the path of this negative off cycle. So this path, that means D2 and D4 is an on condition, D3, D4, D1 is an off condition. So here, this is the regarding positive and negative off cycle. So if you see the picture in some, that means here in terms of the, we apply the AC supply during positive off cycles. These two diodes are on condition, so remaining two diodes are closed, open switches. And during negative off cycle, so these two diodes are on and these two diodes are in open switches. So this is the regarding. And what are the advantages of the full wave rectifiers? Unit centered op amp transformer is eliminated. Because what are the advantages compared to the centered op amp transformer or bridge rectifiers? So bridge rectifiers are the advantage, and there is no need of the centered op amp transformer. And peak inverse voltage is 1/2 the centered op amp transformer. Output is 1/2 the centered op amp voltage. And the defense is required for diode. So interrelation voltage is 1/2 the centered op amp. Okay. So these are the regarding this one. Next is the harmonics. Harmonics means it is different as sinusoidal component of periodic waveform causing a frequency, and this frequency integral multiple of the fundamental waveform. So harmonics are present in waveforms which are not perfect in the waveform, which are not in perfect sine waves. These presence in the rectified output. One can use fundamental frequency and harmonic components in the output by Fourier series expansion of rectifier output current. The output current of the upper rectifier can be present in the Fourier series. I omega t is equal to Im by pi plus Im by 2 sin omega naught t minus 2 Im by pi summation of n to 2 to 4 plus cos n omega naught 2 by n square minus 1. That is the equation number 1. So the output current of full wave rectifier can be present in the Fourier expansion. So this is regarding full wave rectifier. I omega t is equal to 2 Im by pi minus 4 by pi minus integration n equal to even number cos n omega naught by n square minus 1. That means here you can get the signal in the form of the signal. So not only the only single pulses, other pulses are there. So those are the secondary harmonic, third harmonic. That means those harmonic signals will be expressed in the form of the Fourier transform. Okay, Fourier series. So here we can use the Fourier series for a half rectifier, but the output signal can be expressed in the half rectifier by using Fourier series. Similarly, full wave rectifier represents the Fourier series. Okay? And here is from equation 1, the operating frequency is omega naught, which is the lowest operating frequency present in the equation. Hence, the reference frequency is FR equal to F0. From equation 2, we know that the operating frequency is eliminated and the lowest frequency is omega naught, which is a secondary harmonic frequency, hence FR equal to 2F0. That means in the upper rectifier, reference frequency is equal to F0 already, whereas in and second harmonic frequency, yeah, that means in full wave rectifier and reference frequency is equal to twice of the 2F0. So the above is the advantage of the full wave rectifier in the filtering of the output. So another advantage is the current pulses, the two pulses of the transformer running and in such a direction that magnetic cycle is formed through the iron polarization cell that of the AC. So this avoids the desaturation of iron ore from farmer that could give seeds rise to additional harmonics and here is a so here what is filter and how many types of filter there is. Filter means nothing but it converts in pulsating DC into complete DC level in the filter. So the main function of the filter is like to minimize the ripple component, ripple content in the rectifier output. So here there are four types of popular filters are used. So the shunt capacitor filter, series inductor filter, L section filter, and five section filter. Okay. So here we shunt capacitor filters. In this circuit, a capacitor connected directly in the load. So this type of filter, the capacitor input filter or shunt capacitor filter. During the first quarter of the rectifier output, the capacitor charges quickly in maximum value of the diode D1. Once the capacitor reaches the maximum value, the diode D1 becomes reverse biased to stop conducting. So the capacitor recharges with this load resistance. Like during the next quarter cycle, that is from the of the rectifier output voltage. Okay, so during the next quarter of cycle, that is from V to the rectifier output voltage, the capacitor recharges quickly to the maximum value. So diode D2, once the capacitor recharges maximum value, the diode D2 becomes reverse biased and stops conducting. So now the capacitor C recharges to the load ration during the next quarter cycle, that is from the, that means by 225. The voltage across the capacitor same as the voltage across the load ration because those are the connected parallel. According to the follow-up example, the charging of the A1 is very less compared to the discharging them. So due to this, the ripple in the output gets reduced considerably. So here this picture is, so here this is level input signal, that means data transfer could be rectified. So here is D1 here. So there is a capacitor is inserted across the parallel with the resistor, that is load resistor. So here this is the output signal after this is, that means during fall through off cycle the capacitor is charged up to this point, maximum point. So that means automatically the diode D1 conduct whenever D1 is conducted. So the capacity charging to this point, and whenever capacitor is the maximum voltage, so automatically D1 capacitor D1 is automatically not conducting. So that means at the time the capacitor recharges voltage recharges up to the second next cycle is coming. That means this portion. So next during the next off cycle D2 is conducting. So that means here the capacitor charging again maximum value. So whenever capacitor is maximization, then automatically D2 is not conducting. That is off condition. So then the capacitor again recharges and capacitor during the positive cycle this capacitor charges maximum value. This is continuing. That means we can get the this transition. So this is our this portion will be here. So here. So this is the output voltage. So the total charging time is a T1 and recharging time is the total time is T/2. So T1 is less than compared to T2. Charging time is very less compared to the recharging time. Okay. So expression for the ripple pattern for this capacitor filter. So here TB is the time period of the AC input signal. T1 be the time where the diode is conducting. T2 is where the diode is conducting. That means T1 means diode is conducting. T2 means diode is not conducting. So during time T1 capacitor charges quickly. During time T2 is capacitor charges very slowly because time constant RLC is very high and T2 is larger than T1. So that UV gamma is a peak to peak ripple voltage and assume to be a triangular as shown in the diagram. The RMS value of that triangular as shown is given by VRM is equal to maximum value of AC voltage 2/3. That is V gamma by 2/3. That means VRRM is equal to RMS voltage. So during T2 is capacitor recharges to the load ration RL. So the charge lasts during the time T is equal to CV gamma. So but it I is equal to d2/dt. So TV is equal from the integration of 0 to dt. So that is equal to IDC into dt. Therefore IDC into t is equal to C into V gamma. So from this equation V gamma is equal to IDC into T2/C. So but T1 plus T is equal to T/2. T2 is equal to T/2 since T2 is far greater than T1. So discharge time is greater than that charging time. So therefore, V gamma is equal to IDC by T2/2C. So that is equal to IDC/2FC. So but IDC is equal to VDC/RL. That is V gamma is equal to VDC/2FC/RL. So VRRM is equal to V gamma by 2/3 VDC/4/3FC/RL. So that is the ripple factor is equal to 1 by 4 root 3 fc into rl. That is in half a rectifier. That is in full rectifier. But in the case of the half a rectifier, that is a t1 plus t equal t. That equal t2 equal t. Since that means here we can get the output factor is equal to 1 by 2 root 3 fc into rl. That is the difference between the half a rectifier and full rectifier. And next one is the series inductor filter with the full rectifier. So instead of using the capacitor, there is in the inductor. So that means here, whatever the capacitor filter, we are going to remove the AC component and you can get the only pure DC voltage. So for that purpose, we are using the filter. So here, in the capacitor, we are connected parallelly, but the inductor is connected always in series. So if you were to compare the series inductor, so similarly, the inductor of a high reactant, so there is the output. Here is it, that means capacitors allows only AC signal, block DC signal. So inductor allows this signal and offers AC. That means the process always allows AC signal and blocks DC signal. Whereas in inductor is always allows DC signal and opposed AC. Okay. So here we see that the Fourier transformer for full rectifier P is equal to V m by n for m. So this is negating the higher order component. That means we will take first two terms. So that means 2m by V is equal to VDC and 4m by 3 is equal to maximum AC. So we can get the higher RMS value maximum AC value root 2. That is 1 by into 1 by Z. Higher RMS is equal to 4m by 3 by root 2 into 1 by Z. But Z is equal to root and root of the root RL square and XL square. So XL is the that is a reactive component of the inductor, and XC is the reactive component of the capacitor. The reactive is equal to omega L. Okay, so that Z is equal to root of, so we put the value in this equation, that is the final we can get the IDC is equal to Vm by pi RL. So the therefore ripple factor is equal to IR RMS by IDC, that is equal to finally we get the value of the only root of the ripple factor is equal to root 2 by 3 into root 2 by 1 plus 4 omega square L square by RL square. So according to the equation, series inductor will be preferable for AV dose only. So compared to the capacitor, most of the cases we are using series inductor for heavy loads. Okay? And choke input, if you combine these, that means choke input L6 means, so L6 means an inductor filter is increased ripple factor with increased load current, RL load, R load. A capacitor filter has an inverted proportional ripple factor with respect to the load. Economically, both inductor filter and capacitors are not suitable at a high end purpose of the LC inductor. Input or low L section filter consists of the inductor connected in the series with the half of the rectifier and the capacitor at a high. So, whenever inductor is connected in always in series and capacitor connected always in general, the ceramic is also a choke input filter or L section filter because of the shape resembles the interval of the L shape. So to increase the smoothing action, the filter circuit just and one LC circuit will not be enough. Several LC action filters will be arranged to obtain the smooth filter output. The circuit diagram and smooth will not be. So this is the circuit diagram. That means inductor is in connected in parallel with the series and capacitor in connected in parallel. Okay. So this is the regarding this one. Here the ripple factor is equal to 1 by 6 root 2 omega square LC in terms of the that means per LC section filter. Similarly, bisection filter. So bisection means here in the bisection filter or capacitance group filter. So pi means here in, we can use the two capacitors on inductor. So that is the difference between the L section filter. Here in the previous L section filter, we are using only one capacitor one inductor, but here in this we are using two capacitors one inductor. Okay? So the circuit will show here. So here these are the two capacitors one inductor. Okay? So these are the that means here is the ripple factor is equal to root 2 by 8 omega square C1 C2 R load ratio. So here is the capacitor C1 filtering of the circuit and the remaining ripple is removed by the L section filter. So L section filtering L and that means here capacitor is most of the filtering in the circuit and remaining if it is any ripple that will be removed by the L C2. That means here is the C1 C2 C1, C2, L. So first C1 is removing all the AC component, whatever the remaining AC component available in the signal that will be removed by this L and this C capacitors. Okay, so these are the filter circuit. Okay, from this we will conclude this unit.